sorry guys, my camera keeps turning off. I'll check later where exactly I stopped recording, because I've been talking and talking and don't know. So I was saying that we finally took the tree out of the pot, and it looks like it was starting to get root bound. Not really. It doesn't need a repot in an emergency, but the topsoil was really hard and it was really condensed. So we were losing a little bit of percolation there. So what we'll do is we'll take off some of this top dressing. We'll start addressing that. We get to some nice roots. Being pretty gentle, because there is a lot of thick roots here. But those I don't really mind hurting a little or whatnot. The ones I really care for are these fine feeder roots over here. And this top of the soil looks like it's been over-processed, over-colonized with little fine roots. Very little roots here. Very little fine feeder roots. So you know what? I'm feeling really confident just by this, all this growth. And all this, as you can see, look, all this little fine feeder roots right on top of the surface here. That this tree, look at this, look at all of this. They're coming off of these roots here. It's going to do great after this repot. Which is not going to be a full repot. I'm only going to, as you can see, I'm already starting to hit some soil in the form of soil, not really decomposed. And the soil is really starting to open up. Wow, this thing is full of roots. I could feel them as I put my stick through. It's just, oh my God, crawling and crawling with roots. Lots of roots on this juniper procumbens nana that I very much love. And you should too, because it's your tree. I'm doing this for you guys. Let's learn together. Let's do it together. Send me your comments. What would you do to this tree? You tell me. You never know. I might just do it. Lots and lots of roots on this tree. No wonder it was so damn just want to let you guys see that. Look at this. Roots all over the place on this tree. All over, all over. I really would like to expose probably some of this Nabari. Now that I feel so confident and that there's so many roots on this tree. But the Nabari really isn't very wide as per se. So I think we'll keep it like that. I'll do this corner over here. Because I think I'm going to be changing the angle a little bit on this tree. We'll probably be changing the angle. Let's try to loosen up this root so we could probably change the position of it. What I want to do is take this one out. That look, oh my God, look at this. It's going all the way back here. Okay, so let's grab the rake. Start raking from the bottom a little bit. You notice I'm doing this very, very gently. I'm being very gentle with these roots. Even though there's a bunch of them. I just want to spread them out a little bit. On a radio pot pattern. Get rid of this old soil. See these? These are, they don't got no use already. Still got roots all the way down here, this damn thing, huh? It's almost loose. But I want to move this root around. Here it is. It's kind of stuck a little bit, I think. Doing, I don't know what it's feeding. I don't know. So as you can see, there were a lot of roots on the top, but there is not as many in the bottom or on the sides as per that, as per se. even though all this kind of roots were sticking out, so we're not going to cut any roots or nothing like that. We're just gonna let it be, keep growing, change the soil, get nice soil on. It's got a pretty flat surface. So most of these roots are radial roots already. This bonsai has been in training for quite a while, number of years, might say. And now we're just gonna make it great. You and I. So please, like I said before, leave me your comments. What would you do to this tree? How would you go about it? And guess what? You never know. I might just do it. We're gonna grab this one now so we could deal with it a little bit better. With this corners over here and such, without damaging too many roots. Because I really don't want to damage the roots. There are a lot of roots. But then again, these roots gotta feed all of this still. And I'm not styling this year. So I'm not cutting no more off. I'm just gonna let it grow for now. Whatever stood there that we didn't get is gonna stay there. It'll probably get a little trim in the fall, not much. So, we are ready to put this tree in the pot. I'm gonna go clean out the pot and get it ready, and I'll see you guys in a while.